In this session, I'll demonstrate how to invite others to meetings using the Microsoft Outlook calendar. Microsoft Outlook, besides using it for email, can also be used in a powerful way for collaborating with others and choosing the best times to meet and coordinate the meetings with others in your team and in your organization. And that's the main powerful features of Microsoft Outlook, particularly in the corporate environment. It makes it a lot easier to determine what time and when they are available without having to go back and forth with multiple emails as to when it is available. For the sake of demonstration, I cannot use real accounts here for other users, so I have two accounts that we are going to tinker with, and hopefully you'll get the idea as to how to send the alerts and the requests. Basically, once you're in Outlook, then you need to click here on the calendar option. Choose any of those views. Right now it's on the work week. And let's say that for tomorrow on Wednesday, I want to send a meeting request with somebody else. Well, let's say I want my meeting to be at 10 o'clock. So I can either click here on new meeting, or I can simply double click on this time slot from 10 o'clock, and I can put my details for the meeting right here. Specify the location for the meeting, beginning time, end time. You can put the different requirements for it. And then click here under the scheduling assistant. This is going to give you your own calendar. However, you can click here under add attendees, search the global address list in your company for another user in that company. So I'll choose here instructor. It's a generic account, and then I'll add them either as required or optional. So you can pick and choose multiple users in your company from here. And let's say I choose test here, and I have two other users, and I'll make them as optional attendance, and then click OK. Now the system displays their availability and their calendar. By default in Microsoft Outlook, all other users within Microsoft Exchange, they can see when somebody is available. They can't see what you're doing during that time, but they can see when you are available for a meeting with them. The spots in white, that means that they are available. The ones in blue, that means that they are not available. For these other two accounts, that means that they are not using the calendar feature here, therefore no information is available. If I wanted to make it an hour long, I have a conflict with my own schedule here. So you'll also notice some suggested times here on the right-hand side. Notice that they are a little bit earlier in the day for those. However, you can also go and pick here additional times. You can see and pick here the exact block of time that would fit your need where it's available and open. Once you click the specific time that makes sense to you, you can choose a reminder, then you and the person you're requesting a meeting with will be reminded at whatever time you specify here, and then choose whether this is reoccurring or not. Then once you have selected the appropriate time, you can go back to the appointment area and put additional notes that you want to put in this area here. Go here under insert and insert an attachment if you want it for the meeting. Then press send. At this point, the meeting will be added to your calendar, as well as the recipient will receive an email. The email will look like this, and it will basically say, please respond. And I'm accessing this via webmail. If we open this in Microsoft Outlook, it would be something very similar to this. It's basically saying that your request is from such and such an individual, and then the meeting is going to be on such and such a time. This is the attachment. As a user, you can choose to accept it, mark it as tentative, or decline it. If you choose to decline it, the sender is going to receive an alert that the meeting has been declined, and they'll receive an alert provided you choose that you want to send the response back. You can send the response automatically whenever you press the check mark here. Sometimes you can accept the meeting without sending a response. Other times you might be best, if you're not going to be attending the meeting, to just choose edit the response first. Then press send here, and this is the recipient on the other end that is sending this. And if we go back here to Outlook, Notice I received confirmation that it has been accepted, and this will also be in my email here. So it will say accepted meeting for sales 2018, and also it will display the note from the requester. I could actually go here to my calendar and double click on it, and here it says that one has accepted it, zero have declined. And so if you're planning a meeting with multiple individuals, this is a great way for you to coordinate when everybody is available and also track who has accepted it and who has not. Now, the way to track the exceptions is by going here under the tracking option within your appointment. I just double clicked on the appointment. You click on the tracking option and then you'll be able to see who accepted it and what the responses were. Now, sometimes there might be cases where you need to reschedule the meeting and you want to send an alert to the individuals and such. In that case, all you have to do is go back to your calendar, go back to your meeting, and then change the time and date for the meeting. Now, as you're doing this, you might want to check, for example, to use also the scheduling assistant. After you have picked the time and date, you check the availability here. Notice on the 24th, there's not much happening for either one of us here for Friday. Then you select the new time and you go back to your appointment, and then you can put notes and give more details. And then notice, press send update here, and then the recipients on their end will receive an email like this. The old date has been crossed out, the new one, and you need to respond to it. These are the responses from the user side of things. They'll press to send the response as attending it. And then you, as the planner and coordinator of the meeting, you'll receive an alert of the new confirmation from the individual that you invited. So it will be here under the email that they accepted it. And also you can go under the calendar location, double click on it, and then go under tracking. And you can see who has accepted it and who has not. So that's how the whole process works on inviting somebody for a meeting, coordinating the best time for everyone, and checking the tracking who has accepted the meetings and who has not.